the physician shortage, New Jersey losing a lot of physicians, people who may be trained here and go someplace else. Mm-hmm. The new medical education facility, excuse me, the new medical school, it's a partnership. We talk about so many partnerships here.
Right.
The Seton Hall partnerships. Talk about it and why it matters in terms of caring for patients in this state. What is it? Is it 2018?
Yeah, 2018. So we formed a partnership with Seton Hall to establish what will be New Jersey's only private medical school. There is a physician shortage in New Jersey that is more significant than the
national. Is it primary care physicians more than anything else?
Mostly primary care, but also obstetrics and gynecology. It's even general surgery, Steve. So it's widespread. And in just a couple years, by 2020, New Jersey will be short about 3,000 physicians. Nationally, it's about 125,000 physicians. So by having a private medical school, we hope to retain New Jersey residents who want to study medicine right here in New Jersey, and also be able to attract some real talent from out of state. And the statistics show where students go to medical school, they are more likely to practice medicine. So we think this will be a great tool to provide a supply of physicians for generations to come.
Hi, I'm Peter Rooney. In 2006, I lost my father to renal disease. He was on the waiting list for a new kidney, but did not receive one in time. Unfortunately, so many like my father have lost their lives while waiting for a life-saving organ. At New Jersey Sharing Network, we're committed to saving and enhancing people's lives through organ and tissue donation and by informing people about this important decision. Because you can make a difference and save a life.
Also brought to you by Horizon Blue Cross Blue Shield of New Jersey. And by
the New Jersey Office of the Insurance Fraud Prosecutor.